Hey guys, this is video number 4. It's the third one of me today. Today's talk is going to be on the need to suck things up as an actor and a filmmaker. Now this ties in with a lot of the other videos that I'm talking about. I need to constantly though work a specific angle because some of my messages aren't going to cut through to you because it's said in a different way. And other times I want to get super specific with what I'm trying to say in a very super specific manner because it's necessary. There's different things we can talk about with strength as an actor. We could talk about physical strength, vocal strength, you know, resiliency, but it's more about the need to suck things up. It's more about the need to be a hardened beast. To be an artist requires you to be vulnerable, in touch with your emotions, go to different emotions as you're creating, even ones that you don't normally go to. Like for me, I'm a very intense, angry individual because of the way that I was brought up. And that's cool, you know, that's cool. It's got its time and its place. I'm gonna pick up roles where other people can't go. But I also have to understand that the muscles of like love, affection, tenderness, all of those things, they have to be there too. They gotta be in check. I try to keep myself open to both of those extremes because you have to, right? Now, being a filmmaker actor, it's tough. It's fucking tough. I understand it. But if you're in acting school, you can't look to your teacher for love and comfort. They have a hard enough job as it is. You've got to give that to yourself. You have to turn to your support network if you're going through a tough time. You have to speak to your therapist if you're going through a tough time. Your friends, your family, that's what you got to do. That's what you got to do. That's what you got to do to be a professional, man. It's cool to ask help. It's another thing to be a victim who constantly doesn't work towards fixing your issues. I had the toughest time in acting school. One of the worst painful experiences of my life, but it was also the best and most life-changing. And I should have taken the bull by the horns during that time, but instead I had to learn the hard way because I was young, immature, weak, stupid, angry, arrogant, arrogance. Never again, because I understand myself now. I know what my triggers are. I know what sets me off. I know the things I need to work on to keep myself healthy and sane. And that takes time for everyone. It's tough. It's hard. I get it. But it's necessary. Now, if you're a director, filmmaker, you know no one is going to stay on set longer than the cinematographer most of the time on an independent film. If you're a cinematographer, if you're a filmmaker, you've got your own gear, be prepared to put the work in. You're going to be first on set, setting up, carrying shit from your car to the set. You're going to be the last one out. You're going to be driving home. You've got to pack your stuff down, charge your batteries, all that stuff, man. That shit needs to be done by you. By you. By you, man. No one else is going to do it. And what, you're going to complain? You get to be the cinematographer of a fucking movie. Don't complain. Don't complain, man. That's a huge fucking challenge. It's a big responsibility. And it's a shit job sometimes. But think about how much respect people give working cinematographers of big feature films, documentaries, in the industry. You're not going to be respected by the general public because they don't know what they don't know. But if you work hard and you can suck it up and you can accept, it's a tough gig, but I'm going to do it with a smile on my fucking face, you're going to get further. You are going to get further. Trust me on that. Trust me on that. Now, If you're a filmmaker and you're struggling with, like, oh, the creative process, like, this shit, this film script I'm writing, shit, ah, oh, it sucks, blah, 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 blah. You are getting scared of the work process. You're getting scared of going deeper down the rabbit hole with planning, presentation, shot listing, letting it sit in your head, marinating, and growing that creative brief and vision. If you cannot do that, then what are you really scared about? Have you done the work? Have you prepared enough? Like, what is it? What is it? You have to ask yourself these questions. I won't know, because you have to look within to find the answers. There's nothing else. There's nothing else. Making a movie, doing theater, it's grueling, it's painful, requires great energy and discipline. And you can't learn that in a gym. You have to learn that shit doing tough jobs. I said it before, I work a tough job as a freelance AV tech because it builds resiliency and character. I go to the gym, I push myself, I try to grow as much as I can, dialing in my diet now because I need to be that person with enough energy so I can carry a movie, I can carry a production. I want to be a net asset, I want to be a leader, I've got to do those things. I can't be the weakest link in a production. I have to be someone that others can rely on and others can feed off when their confidence is lacking, because that's the kind of artist I want to be. I want to be that. I don't just want to be some lone wolf free agent, you know, maybe even just aloof, just difficult to deal with on set. No, I don't want to be that. I want to grow out of that shit. There's the little things inside of my character and personality, and you're going to experience this too, where you need to get rid of it because it's not going to serve you in your career and your art. It's that simple. That simple. You can't rest. You cannot rest. The reason why I did the video last night, the very first video on my mobile phone, was because I know perfectionism ruins this stuff, and you have to suck up your need for perfection. You're going to aim for it, but you're not going to have the time to make things perfect. I see a lot of cinematographers waste their time making things look pretty when they've got a shot list to get done, when they've got a schedule to stick to. You got to pick and choose and compromise on certain things, because if you don't, well, fuck, what else is there to do, you know? If you're going to act in a play and you got to memorize 70 pages, don't complain about it. Just do it. You asked for it. Nobody, and this is what I hate, nobody has forced you to become an actor. Nobody's twisted your arm into saying yes to a project. You don't like doing the project? Suck it up and be a professional. Just fucking do it. Just do the work, man. I'm just sick of seeing these entitled actors who, you know, act like fucking divas. Just, you know, filmmakers with no clue, no resilience, no drive. There's not, they don't have any pride in what they're doing. Near enough is good enough, whatever. That's okay. You're going to ride the balance of pushing yourself and time and resources that you can get it accomplished with. I'd rather be batting above my average than underachieving and winning a championship. I don't want to underachieve. I don't want to underachieve. It's not good enough just to be like, you know, the Detroit Pistons winning a ring. I want to be like the Golden State Warriors, 73 wins. Like that's the kind of mentality you need. If you have that kind of mentality, where you constantly just... Because the art never ends, man. You go to sleep, you're still an artist. You're still art being created. That's what's up. Most of the good artists out there are working 70 to 90 hours a week. 70 to 90 hours a week. I'm one of them. I don't complain. I've stopped complaining. I've cut that shit out of my life now. Anytime someone asks me, I just go, yeah, I work 70 to 80 hours. And they're like, how do you do it? I just do it. I have to do it. Is it tough? Yeah, it's tough. It's not difficult, not impossible. I can handle it. But I also have to keep in check my need for resting and recovering. But I know myself, I trust myself, I'm honest with myself. So if you're gonna suck things up, make sure you can fucking actually do it. What else needs to be said? Go out there, suck it up, work on the stuff that needs to be worked on, and you'll be able to be a beast, be productive, do your shit, handle it well, keep yourself healthy, get it done.